in the cookbook. There we go. Battery capacity, there it is. I knew that. So I knew we had that somewhere. So what you would do is you would take this policy, this automation policy like that, and you would turn this into, no, I don't. And you would turn this into a, there it is. This one, it's a very simple, okay, not so simple, but it is a PowerShell script that will take a look at the battery age and overall health. So what it does, if I run this, I can see here, what is the minimum capacity left? So a battery, as it degrades, will go from 100% capacity or 102% in some cases, sometimes they're under provision. We tend to see that on higher end devices. When they start getting below their milliamp, they'll go 95%, 90, and so on, and they'll slowly degrade. So if I run this, this is a brand new laptop, so I'm hoping that it's not so bad. Yeah, it's better. It will return the serial number of the battery, which kind of useless, but it's kind of neat. It shows me that it's a 98%. It is a 90 milliamp hour battery. I think that's what it's rated as, is 90 or 95. That's fine. And you're seeing that at the last full capacity charge, it was reporting at 88, which is 98%. Now, the number of batteries in that machine is 1. And then here's all of the details. Now, I can then monitor this through NCentral as a custom service and say, if that number goes below 50 or 60 or whatever, in my personal preference, I would probably do like 65, 70%. In the default, 68. But my preference would be like 65, 70. When the battery goes below that 70, it means that the battery is no longer able to hold a decent charge and will degrade very rapidly. Once the battery reaches about half their life, they tend to die like incredibly fast. It is because of the way that the BMS inside the battery systems are built and how they manage the charge and how they manage their cutoff point. There's a point where they say, you know what, you don't have enough charge anymore, screw you, and they just die. And that happens very rapidly on degrading batteries. So if you are a Dell shop or whatever shop, to be honest, that works. This is a ASUS laptop. That's a an ROG Strix, and it does that, and it returns that health either way. It does for absolutely anything, any device that reports a battery. And it compares the rated milliwatt hour to the full capacity of the last charge. So this is not what it is right now. I could be at half capacity, and that would still report the last full charge of that battery and its health. So this is in the cookbook. You can already grab it. I don't need to reinvent the wheel. It's already there for you. Go grab it. You'll notice. All right. What I was going to say is you have a NCentral version and an RMM version. Just make sure to grab the NCentral one. We do this because the RMM platform, the Enable RMM platform, works differently than NCentral. And there's some things that you cannot do in one that you can't do in the other. So we tend to build that differently. So that's just something to keep in mind. You can grab whichever one you need from there. And that applies to a lot of new things that we build. It tends to see show NCentral and so here versus RMM.